Experiment 31 deals with enzymes and the factors that affect enzyme activity. Let's have a look at the pre-lab review pages. Question number one asks about safety alerts. Remember that you'll look for the triangle icons. Question number two, always the same. Disposal directions, look for the garbage can icons. And number three says, what observation is used in all parts of the experiment to indicate that polyphenol oxidase has acted on a substrate? You'll look for the formation of a brown color. And I mention the answer because I'd like to just say a word or two right here. You've all cut an apple or peeled a banana, and you notice that after a few minutes, a brown color starts to develop. That's what we're looking at here. It's the same thing, the action of the enzyme polyphenol oxidase. And when an apple is exposed to oxygen, the enzyme is active and you get that brown color. The rest of these are pretty straightforward, the pre-lab review pages. Let's have a look at the data and report. In part B, you're looking at enzyme specificity, where we vary the possible substrate. And over here on the right-hand side, you'll record color intensity. And I just want to caution you, you don't want to record the color. You want to record the intensity of the color. That means how dark it is. And so you use this plus, plus, plus scale that they mention, or a minus if there's no activity. In part C, you're looking at substrate concentration. Here on the left side is where you'll record your data. The color intensity, again, using the same scale of plus, 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 and so on. And then on the right-hand side is the report part of part C, where you'll plot this information. And just for the sake of being able to plot this, let's say that at a relative substrate concentration of 2 in test tube D, you recorded the color intensity as plus. How would I plot that information? Well, down here on the x-axis is the relative substrate concentration, so I'd find 2, and I'd go up with a hypothetical line from 2. I'd come across from the intensity, plus, and where those two hypothetical lines intersect, I'd put a dot. You'd do that with each piece of information. So let's say that test tube C, with a relative substrate concentration of 4, well, maybe it would give us 2 pluses. We'd come down to 4 again and go up with a hypothetical line, come across from plus plus, where those two hypothetical lines intersect, we'd place a point. You'd do that for test tube B and test tube A. So you'd have 4 points on this graph. Then you'd take a line and draw a smooth line connecting those points. And that's how you construct a graph. Part D, looking at enzyme concentration, same scale, plus, 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 and color intensity here once again. You have 4 different relative enzyme concentrations, and I've indicated these locations over here in the graph at the right, at 1, at 5, at 10, and 15. So here at 5, for example, you'd go up with a hypothetical line, you'd come across with the color intensity, whatever it is, you'd place a point at that location, get 4 points on the graph, and again, connect them with a, draw a smooth line connecting the points. Effect of pH, same strategy. Here's our intensity scale. 4 different pHs are used. You'll record the color intensity. You'll graph that information over here on the right. Effect of temperature, once again, 3 different tests, 3 points here on the graph, and you'll draw the appropriate lines. Part G looks at the impact of inhibitors and use the same intensity scale. You'll record the intensity over here on the right.
And it's 6 o'clock.
And you won't graph the information in this case, though. Then we come to the questions at the end of the chapter. These are pretty much based upon the graphs that you draw, except for number 5. It says, which of the following processes is most likely to take place as a result of the influence of temperature on enzyme activity? I'll tell you the answer here. It's A that we're after, but I'd like you to explain why, if you would. And that completes the experiment. I hope you enjoy it. Remember to send me an email or give me a call if I can help.